It's a true rags-to-riches Cinderella story with a storybook ending, complete with a Prince Charming and a castle. A little girl's dream realized, from singing in bars to one of the biggest recording artists of all time. CMT star, Flashback Shania. Eileen Twain grew up in the small northern town of Timmins, Ontario. She later adopted the name Shania. She began singing when she was 3 years old, and her mother was proud of little Eileen.
Instead of my mother being embarrassed and telling me to be quiet, she put me up on the countertop a couple of times in the restaurant to sing for everybody along with the music. So that was the real beginning.
After graduating from high school, her first full-time gig was singing at a resort called Deerhurst in a Vegas-style revue.
The way I look at it is I kind of went off to college for a little while and did a lot of music college and did a lot of other kinds of music, musical theater and R&B and rock and all kinds of music for my later teenage years. And explored my limitations, you know, really just, and taking myself beyond those things to learn. That's how you learn, right?
Working at Deerhurst, I had to learn. It was kind of fun, actually. It was like going to school in a way because I, like I said, I did have to learn how to move quickly in high heel shoes and learn a little bit of choreography, and I wasn't good at it. I mean, I never learned how to dance or anything like that, so the girls there were very patient with me, and they would teach me, you know, the simplest routines, the ones that they thought I could handle.
It was at Deerhurst that the young singer's life changed forever when an executive from Nashville saw her perform.
He said, well, I'm impressed and I'm willing to call a couple of people in to see if they might be interested in producing you or possibly getting you a record deal. And so I did go to Nashville.
Eileen Twain had completed her first phase of evolution. Soon the whole world would know Shania.
I still remember how much pride my parents instilled in us as far as looking your best and being proud of the way you look. And so I've always thought that was part of being an entertainer.
As we all know, Shania rivals Madonna for the number of looks she's created over the years. In his pocket and a comb up his sleeve, just in case, and all that extra whole gel in your hair, I'd lock it. Cause heaven forbid it should fall out of place. Oh, well, you think you're special.
If you look at every video that she does, she's trying to do a different, complete, separate look. And it's not a bad strategy because we keep looking. We keep looking to see what is Shania wearing. And it really works.
She always looks good. I think it is gorgeous, though, when she wears the long gowns, like in the new video, Don't. The corseted gowns that are really, like, striking. And, you know, she's very natural nowadays with her makeup and everything.
In Shania's ever-changing persona with her style, one of the great things is her hair also. She's got beautiful hair, but she keeps changing the color, whether it's the cut. I've noticed she's gone from dark brown to almost a red, to a little bit of a blonde, to back to dark brown again. And hair is one of those great styling things where just a slight change can alter your look entirely. And I think she recognizes that, and she sort of uses her hair to her full advantage.
I love the fact that she's always had long hair, because so many people will say to a woman who has long hair, you should cut it, go for something different, you know, cut it all off and everything, and she never has. She's always had long hair, and it suits her, and I think, you know, a woman that knows how she looks good doesn't need to change it.
She has the ability to go out and actually change people's perception on fashion and what's acceptable, what isn't acceptable, the Jennifer Aniston of music, you know, I want my hair to look like Shania's.
Shania has relied on many talented makeup artists to assist her with her always evolving style. This wasn't always the case. When Shania first hit the scene, she was content with handling her own makeup. But that didn't last long.
She's gone from sort of fresh-faced country girl to glamazon. I mean, her latest video I saw, she had at least 4 inches of eyelashes, fake eyelashes. I mean, it's very, very, very glamorous. With lots of money and things.
I developed very young, and I hated the fact that I didn't adjust very well to, like, breasts. It's like I'm bouncing. I don't like this, you know. It's like I was a gymnast when I was young, and I was like, oh, you know, somebody tape these things down. I can't deal with this. And I hid myself all the time, and I wore big, huge sweatshirts and tracksuits. And my father, you know, both my parents would just say, you know, you don't have to be embarrassed about your figure. You know, be proud of your figure. You're very athletic, you're in great shape. Don't be shy.
Let's go, girls.
Shania may have been self-conscious as a young teen, but years later, she was more than comfortable with her looks and provocative outfits.
I'm not sexual, visually, but I don't mind being femininely sexy. I don't mind that at all.
Shania is very sexy, whether or not she admits to it or whether she's aware of how sexy she is.
She rocked Nashville and the conservative world of country music right from the beginning with her belly button.
Her imaging was fresh and country and lots of navel, which was, you know, I think the new thing, the shocking thing about her, and who couldn't look at that, you know, and say, oh my goodness, you know, whether it was a man or a woman, it was, you know, she has one of the most beautiful tummies I've ever seen.
My teens, I was watching Madonna and Janet Jackson and all that. I mean, they always wore open midriff. I didn't see any, like, I didn't think it was doing anything new. But it was new for Nashville, and I didn't realize that.
Shania likes to think that she can make no fashion mistakes, that she can wear just about anything. I don't think that's true. I think she probably needs a little bit of editing or a little bit of guidance. A lot of her outfits tend to be over the top, which is normal for a music star like herself, because it works on stage. Whether or not it works in the real world, it's who's to say, you know? But I think it's a little bit over the top.
She is the Madonna of country music, really, when you think about it, because Madonna was always doing that. She was always shocking the industry with her look. Every time Shania does an award show, she always has a unique custom outfit on, and everyone always is dying to see what she's going to be wearing, women and men alike, you know, and I think that that it takes a really unique person to be a trendsetter like that.
There is no question that Shania is always stunning, regardless of her choice of style. But let's check out the music, because it's the music that has made Shania a superstar. Her first trip to Nashville was a partial success. Shania landed a big-time record deal, but she didn't really feel at home.
You're new in town, and there's so many songwriters there, so many publishing houses, and you know, I wasn't just going to walk into town and everybody was going to go, wow.
True enough, her self-titled debut album fell flat. But her first video caught the eye and ear of one of the most prominent producers in music history, Robert Mutt Lang.
He had my first CD. He was a fan. He was intrigued by my voice, wanted to know if I was a songwriter.
They decided to work together and then soon fell in love and got married. Together, they created the singer's second album, The Woman in Me.
Not only did it explode, her career, but I think it really changed the course of country music.
Enough people in the industry believed in it, enough to give it a chance. And then as soon as the fans got a hold of it, they took it away. Thankfully. I'm so thankful for that. Because I don't think I would, I just wouldn't want it any other way. I wouldn't want to have to mold myself to please everybody. I just wouldn't be happy.
there were people in Nashville that I think literally hated me. I mean, maybe, and they probably still are. I mean, there's like this love-hate relationship with Shania Twain, you know, and it just really stirred everything up.
I felt triumphant for her because I know she had struggled with kind of the robotic being told what to do and who to write with and, you know, and it just didn't, she didn't want to be that. So for her to have the strength to seek out her dream was so encouraging for me at the time.
Success came quickly, but unlike her peers, she chose not to tour. Instead, Shania released a number of sexy videos. Her songs climbed the charts, and she began to sell millions of albums. With the huge success of The Woman in Me, Shania became a true international music and video star.
Like her physical change in her hair and her makeup and her outfits, she was always making groundbreaking videos and videos that had an expectation of being different and being unique and that she was going to look amazing in, no matter what. And I think I can't recall too many videos of Shania's that I wasn't like, you know, dying to see the premiere and then really quite pleased with, you know, what we got to see.
Any man of mine, I just thought, you know, what great attitude. She seemed really spunky, and I love the fact that she had the horses in there, and she's kept that through a lot of her videos, and I love horses, so I think she makes a great video.
Come On Over was album number 3. It set sales records and introduced a whole new crop of Shania videos. Her music was now appealing to people all over the world.
The thing that people really miss about Shania Twain, I think, is she's writing about herself, her life, things around her, and she's looking at things in a very positive light. It's impossible not to hear a Shania Twain song on the radio and not be taken in. Think about it.
Well, I wanted this album to be very, I did want it to be very conversational, so I'm glad you're reading it that way. That's a compliment, because it was really my intention to make it very conversational, make it very personable.
When it went 5 times platinum, I thought to myself, wow, the fans are into this music.
I think the great thing, I think, is time went on, her and Mutt just obviously found this chemistry that, you know, that works. I mean, the great thing about her music is that it just, sometimes it's the sentiment of it, but I think more times than not, it's the what you feel out of it. You know, it's the beat, it's the
energy.
There's a tremendous amount of excitement that is going on in my life right now. It's a whirlwind of excitement. It's just up, 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 up.
I like her ability to reach, I'm gonna say, the common woman and the common man, because she sings about things people can relate to. She's not afraid to take a chance lyrically. She's not afraid to shock a little bit. And I think that she's really real. And you get a sense of the nice small town girl that she grew up as.
With all the success, it was inevitable that Shania would release a greatest hits album.
5 years from now, I'd like to see more artists recording my songs. I'd love to have, as a songwriter, I'd love to see other artists recording my music. And to be honest with you, I don't really know, because I never really planned that far ahead. It's a really great time for me to be able to reflect on everything that's been achieved and all of the accomplishments. It's great to review the songs that have just done so many great things for me. It's a great time to reflect, and it feels really good.
Okay, so she's had massive success with her videos and music. Now it's time to get the scoop on the man in her life. How did she fall for a guy named Mutt?
Who's Mutt Lang? And I said, that is such a strange name, Mutt. Who would call himself Mutt?
Mutt had already produced and written with Bryan Adams, AC/DC, Foreigner, The Cars, and Def Leppard when he first pursued Shania.
We ended up becoming phone friends. We ended up getting to know each other over the phone about a month before Fanfare. And he said to me, you know, I noticed that you have a song on this album that you wrote. He said, I think it's really good. I want to hear more of your writing. Because he said, I'm a songwriter as well. And I said, oh, okay. So we started writing some songs over the phone.
I was in heaven with Mutt. I had somebody who was interested in my songwriting, who thought my ideas were creative, somebody who loved my vocal style and just loved to sit there and listen to me sing.
We continued writing, and I made several trips to England to finish writing the album. And we fell in love and got married, and it all happened, just one big whirlwind.
The time together has really helped us evolve creatively as co-writers.
The way he influences me as a songwriter is he'll push me to limits that I wouldn't necessarily push myself. Not just as a songwriter, but also as a singer. He knows what I sound like in a more intimate environment. I'll be, whether I'm cooking dinner or sitting around with my guitar and singing a few things here and there.
Mutt doesn't want to be a star. He doesn't want to be famous. He wants to be a producer and a songwriter, you know. He loves his privacy. He wants to keep it. And he's not a hermit or anything like that. I mean, there's been a lot of silly rumors. He just wants to be a normal guy. And the problem is that because he now has a famous wife, he's finding it more difficult to maintain that.
To maintain their privacy, Shania and Mutt now call Switzerland and a castle home. Shania Twain has lived the rags-to-riches story.
I will never forget the days of rags. I still live in rags often. I mean, I actually love very much where I come from. I love what I've been through as a child. No lunch at school, you know, kind of grouping food and rations, you know. It's like, I like looking back on that. I'm not ashamed of it. My parents did their best. For a long time, actually, there has been nothing that I've wanted. For a very long time. Ever since my parents died. Are you kidding? It's like, what else could you want except your family alive and well? What more do you want than that? You realize very quickly that there is nothing else in life. And so I discovered that a long time ago, long before success and all of these things, that I had already had everything I ever wanted. And the only thing I could ever want is my parents back, and it is never going to happen. So, you know, you got to be happy with what you've got.
Shania Twain has evolved from a young child singing in Canadian bars to one of the world's most popular entertainers. From backbreaking work in the bush to strolling the grounds of her estate in Switzerland, many things in her life have changed, and she certainly has had to live through personal heartbreak. But it's a combination of music, talent, image, and determination that has made her so wildly successful.
To give it my all, and you know what? If I don't get anything out of it, or don't get what I hope to get out of it, that's okay. You have to let it be water, you know, off your back and just go on, and not let that get you down. And you know, then you'll end up being pleasantly surprised, because if you do work hard, things do usually come your way.
You know, when you reach the top of a mountain, you get up there, and now you can see all these other mountains, or all the, you know, you see things differently. I feel like I have a better view of an overall view of things, and I feel like the sky's the limit now.